Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. Recently, it looks like y'all have really been enjoying our videos about corgis, what it's like to have one. So today we thought we would make another video about corgis. And this time I wanted to focus on weird things that corgis do. These dogs have so much personality, Chibi especially here, and I know each and every one of them is unique, but there are definitely some personality quirks that I've come to know and love about corgis. And Chibi in particular. Today I'm gonna share some of these weird corgi quirks. And if you have a corgi, leave a comment below and tell me if your corgi does any of these weird things, or let me know if it's just Chibi that's weird. The first thing that I notice a lot of corgis do is that they will suck on beds. For Chibi, she likes to lick the couch. I don't know why, there's nothing on the couch, it's very clean, there's no food or leftover crumbs, or maybe there is, I don't know. I know that licking is a really calming behavior for dogs, so it's really common for them to self-soothe and lick things, so if you give them a Kong, for example, it's really good for them. But Chibi always leaves these wet marks about the size of, you know, a grapefruit on our couch, and I'll come home from work or wherever I've been and there'll be three random wet spots all over the couch. That's definitely one of the first weird things that I noticed about her. But after meeting other corgis, I realized a lot of them have the same sort of thing where they like to lick couches or suck on their beds. I've posted stories about this before and other people tell me that their corgis do the same thing, but I've never really seen any other dogs do it. Kokoro doesn't do it. So to me, this is definitely kind of a weird corgi quirk. Speaking of couches, another weird thing that Chibi does is she uses pillows like humans do. She will climb on top of pillows, make a nest out of them, and actually lay her head on it and rest like we would. This is something that I have not noticed Kokoro do. Kokoro is very much a dog bed or floor kind of dog. She likes mats. She likes actually laying on our bean bags and dog beds. Chibi will use pillows on our couch and actually arrange them so that they're serving the same purpose that we use pillows for. Another weird thing that Chibi does is she really likes to hide under the bed. I don't know, again, if this is an all corgis weird thing to do. Oftentimes, I'll just find a random drumstick sticking out from under my bed and look underneath and there will be a Chibi there. She does this when we go to hotel rooms. It's pretty much one of the first things she does if we do travel, actually, is go under the bed. Maybe there are leftover crumbs or food from previous guests, which is actually kind of gross, but she has found an affinity for really small, tight spaces like being under the bed. She actually also did this a lot at my last office where we had a coffee table and it was one of those coffee tables that had a top layer and then a bottom layer and then it was on wheels. So there was basically, you know, this much space between the two layers and she would crawl in between the layers as if it was like her own little tunnel or crate. She definitely loves being in small, dark spaces, especially underneath furniture, and that's definitely one of her weirdest quirks. Oh, this next one is actually one of my favorite things that I discovered about corgis. At first, I thought this was kind of just a Chibi thing, but then I looked through some footage where we were hanging out with another corgi, and this corgi was doing the same thing. Chibi always likes to make the curb of a sidewalk into her own personal corgi-sized sidewalk. So she will walk on that edge where the actual curb is drawn or separated in the cement and balance on that, and it kind of is the perfect size for her four little feet and acts as a corgi-sized sidewalk. I've noticed her do this in multiple different places, different types of material for the ground, and it's kind of funny to me because obviously they can see that there is a separation, but I'm not sure what's going on in their minds when they're thinking, oh, I'm just gonna walk on this perfectly me-sized little part of the sidewalk. Again, please, other corgi owners, let me know in the comments if your dog does this so I can tell if it's just Chibi that's kind of weird or if all corgis are just really quirky. Another weird thing that all corgis do is that they talk. So I know all dogs pretty much can bark and they make different types of vocalizations, but corgis are quite chatty dogs and they will actually talk to you. They will also listen to you and they have the best head tilts. So here's an example of me asking Chibi a bunch of stupid questions and just take a look at her reaction.
Chibi, are you a dog? Chibi, are you a Chibi? Do you want snacks? Do you want dinner? Do you want to say hi? Cheeps, is it dinner time? Is it time for dinner?
I think this sort of comes from the fact that Corgis are filled with personality. They're definitely very smart and able to communicate really easily with humans. Part of that communication too is their excitement. So another weird thing that Corgis do, and this is probably the most well-known or popular Corgi quirk, I would say, is that they wiggle their bodies uncontrollably when they're excited. So other dogs have tails, long, beautiful tails that wag and basically show off how excited or happy the dogs are. I feel like Corgis kind of know that they kind of have to make up for it and wiggle their bodies extra to show off how excited they are. This is definitely something Chibi does anytime she sees somebody that she knows or she's trying to get pets from a stranger. I just can't get enough of how adorable her wiggly body is. I realize a lot of these things may be applicable to other dogs as well, but I feel like they are quite Corgi-specific behaviors just because of their breed and their temperament and what they were bred to do. But every dog has their unique personalities, and this is kind of just my take on the specific weird things that Chibi does. The last weird thing that Chibi does is probably my favorite Chibi quirk, and I have even shared an Instagram story highlight on this, and we call it Chibi doing Chibi things. Basically, she loves rolling around on the ground. I don't know if it's her getting a back scratch and it feels really good, but sometimes she like digs her face, her like muzzle and her paws all into it. I have countless videos of her doing this, and I know a lot of dogs do this in the grass. It feels really good and they're really happy and they're, you know, wiggling their backs. The grass is actually one of the only places that she doesn't do it. But she will do it here on the rug every single morning after she eats. Her routine is to eat her breakfast and then go do her Chibi things on the rug. She likes to do it in the sand. She has done it in California. She has done it in Utah, in Arizona. She does it on everybody's rugs. This is probably my favorite thing because it really just shows how comfortable and happy they are. I think it's really them like getting their scent on things scientifically. It's probably my favorite Corgi quirk, and it's something that I never ever see Kokoro do. Kokoro will do it where other dogs, I think, typically do as well, which is to sort of hide their scent on something that they might find in nature. So it's really disgusting, but she'll do it on like horse manure or a slug or something really stinky. She actually did it once in goose poop. She doesn't really tend to do that. She just does it, I think, for like the texture. So the texture of the rug, the texture of the sand, it feels really cool. So yeah, that's basically it for our Chibi quirks. I'm gonna call them Corgi quirks, but you guys tell me in the comments whether this is reflective of your Corgi and the weird things that they do. And if there's something that I missed that you find is a super weird personality trait of all Corgis, let me know that in the comments as well. Thanks so much for watching. You guys know I love talking about dogs, about corgis. Hope you all enjoyed, and we'll see you next time.